An annuity is a series of payments or a stream of payments of a similar amount for a fixed time period. Annuities are very common in corporate finance. You have many applications of annuity. For example, if you are making an investment by purchasing a life insurance endowment scheme, and every year if you make a 10,000 rupees for the next 10 years, this is an example of annuity. Similarly, you may save ₹1,000 in a recurring deposit of a bank or a post office for a period of 25 years. This is another example of annuity. And on the other side, if you borrow an educational loan from a bank and where you have to pay a monthly installment called as equated monthly installment, is another example of annuity of a present value. Similarly, when corporates borrow loans from banks and financial institutions, they pay the loans in installments, whether it may be a quarterly installment, half yearly installment, or an annual installment. This is another example of annuity. In this video, I give you more details about what is annuity and what are the different types of annuities. When we say an annuity, annuity has what three features. One is it's a series of payments, or say stream of cash flows, and then similar amount, or you can say the same amount, and then for a fixed period. So for example, if you are making an investment of ₹10,000 every year for next 10 years. So here 10,000 is a similar amount, and 10 years is a series, and this is a fixed time period. Now when it comes to the annuities, you will come across with the two forms of annuity. One is a future value annuity. This is your future value annuity, and second is present value annuity. In case of future value annuity, you are making an investment or there is a cash outflow, and in case of present value, you are receiving a revenue and there is a cash inflow. And another aspect of annuity is that the annuity may be classified into two. One is ordinary and the second one is due. That means this is annuity ordinary and this is annuity due. So in case of annuity ordinary, the investment or the cash flow will be at the end of the period, whereas in annuity due, it is in the beginning of the period. I'll show you this on a timeline. Suppose if you have an annuity ordinary, future value annuity ordinary, in this case if you are making an investment for 5 years and 10,000 rupees at 5%. So here is your timeline where you start with a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this is 0. So your cash flows will be at the end of the first year, you'll make a 10,000. Second year, another 10,000. Third year, another 10,000. Fourth year and fifth year. So this is your, assuming that you are making an investment. And on the other side, if it is a future value annuity due, in this case, your investment, that is at a time 0 and a time 5. So first you will make a cash flow of 10,000 here, investment. Then beginning of the first year, beginning of the second year, beginning of the third year, and beginning of the fourth year. So you'll have a 5 series of payments. The difference is that in case of ordinary cash flow, you are making investment at the end of the year, whereas in ordinary due, you are making investment in the beginning of the year. Or if you are receiving a cash flows, you are receiving a cash flows in the beginning of the year. In this case, you are receiving a cash flow at the end of the year. In the coming videos, I'm going to explain you how to calculate future value of annuity ordinary, future value of annuity due, and with the different forms. Thank you.